This segment of the news is brought to you by Smitty's Cards and Coins. Would you like to know what your collectibles are worth? Come by 2281 Postal Road, Unit 4, across from the post office.
Well, we've all seen those drivers driving in and out of traffic, cutting vehicles off, tailgating, distracted, or speeding. Those are all hazardous moving violations. But for drivers driving semi-tractor trailers, those violations are even more hazardous. Tractor trailers and their load can weigh as much as 80,000 pounds. They require a longer distance to stop than most vehicles. They are not as agile as a passenger car and have big blind spots. The Nevada Highway Patrol will be conducting Badge on Board this week to catch those drivers that commit hazardous moving violations around semi-trucks. The main reason the Nevada Highway Patrol is conducting these operations is because motor vehicle crashes involving semi-trucks, for obvious reasons, tend to have greater risk to bodily injury and death. An Andre Butch Harper Act of Kindness Award was presented to a volunteer with the Nye County Sheriff's Office Auxiliary. Jose Tejas presented the award in Butch's honor.
This is the kindness award that was Butch Harper used to give out to everybody that worked with our community. And it was an honor for me to come up. And as you know, I'm wearing my Marine jacket and everything. The reason being is he was a veteran also. And he was really a good man. Marilyn, it's a great pleasure to honor you today with the Andrew Butch Harper Act of Kindness Award. And he always gave this with a lot of heart. So I'm trying to be a lot of heart. Thank you very much for everything you do for our community.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, Marilyn's been with us for 18 years as a member of the auxiliary, the Sheriff's Department. Last month, she was recognized as a founding member of the unit back when the things first started. It was a community action team. And now she is involved as a historian, not only having firsthand knowledge, but she has also volunteered her time to do our records and keep some of that history alive. She also works with the Sheriff's Evidence Department, and she is very involved in that. So that's the kind of people that really keep this thing going.
So it was great to award her the Andre Butch Harper Act of Kindness Award today. Thank you so much for having us.
No, I appreciate you guys coming, and it was meant a lot to her, I'm sure, and to all of us. We appreciate it.
Congratulations once again to Marilyn Tisdale. There's an event happening on Friday at Inspiration Senior Living. Tonya Brum explains.
On March 3rd, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., they're having an anniversary party, Welcome to Pahrump for Grace Management. It'll be their first year as the management team running it. There's going to have raffle prizes and a ribbon cutting, but it's being done specifically to honor Andre Butch Harper. Everybody knows him, and to celebrate Butch's life by having this event. And it's a ceremony in memory of Butch. There'll be ribbon cutting, live entertainment all day long, refreshments, raffle prizes. There'll be a lot of other businesses there too. The doors will be open. It's open to the public. They're inviting everybody to join them and to walk through the inspirations and meet the residents and meet the staff.
They're even going to have an unveiling of a bench, I think, in his name.
Yes, they are. So, which is kind of cool because Butch did so much for the community. And they wanted to show how much they appreciated Butch. So that's part of one of the ceremonies along with the ribbon cutting.
Where's Inspirations at?
Inspirations is at 931 East Honeysuckle Road. If you turn west on Honeysuckle and go all the way to the end, you just can't miss it. It's the biggest building on the area.
It's a three-story building right there off of Pahrump Valley Boulevard and Honeysuckle. Just go west and you'll find it there. For more information, there's a number to call.
Yes, call 775 751-2300.
And what date is it?
It's March 3rd. It's on a Friday. I'm sorry. It's on a Friday, March 3rd.
And so that all begins at what time?
It begins at 11 in the morning, and it'll run till 3. And it's a wonderful opportunity for people to get familiar with this wonderful living accommodations for seniors.
Know how when you have a party, everyone seems to end up in the kitchen? Designers have noticed too. And because of it, a fixture in modern kitchens that started out as a plain Jane option has become an essential part of the room. In this Angie's List report, we see how kitchen islands have grown in size, stature, and complexity in the last 50 years.
The first kitchen island was designed as a food prep zone. Today, they're the focal point of the room that many consider the heart of the home.
Kitchen islands have been a mainstay in kitchens for decades, but they've really changed over the last few years, from being just plain rectangular structures to actually being almost a kitchen in themselves.
Randy Sorrell of Surroundings Remodelers says since the Great Recession ended, kitchens have taken on new meaning, appearance, and functionality.
Whenever you have a dinner party, whenever it's Christmas or any holiday, you may start outside or you may start in the living room, but you end up in the kitchen. And now, predominantly, you're hanging around the island.
The size and features of islands today are limited only by the size of the room, and some people are tearing out walls to create even more room for larger islands.
Really dream big about what you might want to do with that island and talk to your contractor, because you could have a stove, you could have a sink, you could have all kinds of things as a part of that island.
Elaborate kitchen islands are one of the main reasons dining rooms are disappearing from modern homes.
If you have the space in your kitchen, you put in an island. If there's space and opportunity for chairs around the island, oh man, I mean, that's a home run. And so that seems to be a huge objective.
This is Katlyn Boyer reporting for News 46.
Thanks, Katlyn. Angie says big box stores sell kitchen islands for as little as $120. But a custom island that includes a sink, ventilation, and cooking appliances can top $6,000. As with any remodel, ask your contractor what they can do on your budget. When we return, a word from cardiologist Dr. Eric.